Hello, welcome to another PieFinder mission. Today we are trucking, as you can see. I'm with John Hawke, another PieFinder member.
Hello.
So, we're doing a run from Paris to... let me have a look. To Linz, which is a nice 14-hour run. I picked up from Paris and parked in the local service station so I can turn on my radio and set up for recording and so on and so forth. John is also playing, because we're playing Euro Truck multiplayer. He's driving from Sheffield to Linz, so hopefully we will meet him some point along the way.
Aye, I hope so.
If we don't crash.
Can't
so, I'm driving the new Volvo truck, fully maxed out, completely kitted, 750 brake horsepower. It is an absolute beast of a truck. I did have a Scania, which I did say in a previous video was the best truck. However, I'm kind of torn between the two now, between Volvo and Scania.
Boo.
Hawk has a Scania.
Scania the best.
They are, but I like Volvo as well. I do have the radio on in the background in the game, so you might hear Magic FM. You might have a bit of a sing-song along the way as well.
Oh, what an idiot. Instead, I had a head-on crash. So I was on the wrong side of the road.
I will warn viewers, this is not my best driving, because I'm concentrating on several different things at once. So, I will try my best to obey the traffic laws as best as I can. It won't always happen. There will probably be crashes, bumps, scrapes along the way, but it's all part of the fun of trucking.
Well, someone's jackknifed.
It wasn't me.
For a change.
I don't jackknife that often. So what are you carrying, Hawk?
Carrying a 25-ton excavator.
I am carrying, let me have a look. Pressure tank. 22 tons of pressure tank. As you can see, the careful viewers here will notice that my mileage is only 590. This is a brand new, recently bought truck. I've only done two or three trips with it now. A lot of people on the multiplayer trucking forum recommended the Volvo, and as you'll probably see, there are tons of Volvos that people drive, especially the brand new ones. Scania and Volvo tend to be the two biggest trucks you'll see. I just love the interior of this truck, it's so nice.
Yeah, the Volvo may have a nice interior, but I don't know. I just don't like when the seating position is really low down for me.
Well, apparently, I was reading on Steam, you can change the update, the seating updates. Like, you can update your seating position. You know, like you can with your mirrors and stuff.
Yeah.
You can change your seating camera, so you can sort of have it more to your liking.
I'm going to have to give another try on a different profile.
I am using a steering wheel for this, as I use for all my trucking games, using the Logitech G27 racing wheel, the best steering wheel there is, well, the only steering wheel there is really. I did have a Mad Catz Xbox steering wheel, which wasn't bad, it did the job, but the G27 is just, well, it's just amazing.
Amazing.
I am driving automatic for this trip. I'm not driving manual as well. It's just easier to drive and talk without having to worry about gear changing. I'm just being lazy today.
Like always.
It's a bit harsh.
Well, I'll tell the truth.
Right, the toll booth. See, there's my trailer, the pressure tanks there. 12 hours and 6 minutes to go. I'm cruising with a bit of James Blunt.
Mm. I'm just going to ferry now.
To ferry. As you can tell, John's from up north.
Up north.
Up to north.
I don't know why you always think we always say tut north.
Tut north. Oh, hello, we've got a roadblock here. Just on the junction I want to come off of. What are these Muppets doing? As you can see, a trucker is trying to reverse down the slipway back onto the motorway, I think, and he's making a right hash of it. I'm just going to try and sneak past them. Let them know I'm coming. I know that was probably a bit unrealistic, but I'm not going to sit there for 20 hours while he tries to reverse a trailer down a slipway. If I wanted to do that, I'd become a real trucker. I've got the belly for it. So if you've not come across the multiplayer, it is available in alpha stage at the moment. I think it's alpha version 1.004, I think, at the moment.
Yeah.
You can download it from the ETS multiplayer website, which I'll link in the video. There's about 2,000 people on the server, covering the whole of the map. It's not always busy. There are huge quiet periods, especially around the UK on the map. Most people tend to sort of stay around Europe, France, Germany, Holland, you'll find. Try and avoid Holland as best you can. You have to. I was stuck in a 2-hour traffic jam. A couple of nights ago, there was about 50 to 100 trucks just piled up.
Talk about that. I'm in Amsterdam right now.
I hope you don't get stuck.
I know.
Oh, there's another UK trucker, I think.
Mashed potato.
Do the alligator. We're listening to both random radio stations in our trucks.
Ooh.
Oh, wait, you listening to Magic?
I am.
You must be ahead of me then. Man. Yeah, I've just got the mashed potato song come up.
Oh, oops.
This is going to be tricky. Oh, that's not going to work.
Step, give me that. Mashed potato.
That is the danger of playing multiplayer. Trying to overtake on a bend, which I know you shouldn't do, but with no traffic. Sometimes you get away with it, sometimes you don't. I didn't. But luckily I saw the truck coming before we had a massive smash. So I just have to sit behind this guy until I can get a clear road. The advantage of driving a 750 brake horsepower Volvo is you get incredible pull. I think it's something like 3,500 newton meters of torque, which will literally pull anything, and you can get up to really decent speeds in the Volvo as well. As with the Scania, which I think also has a 750 brake engine.
Scania's highest is 730, I think.
Is it 730?
Yeah. But I think it pulls more or less RPM than the Volvo. So you get a bit more eco-friendly engine.
This is a beautiful part of the world. I love the detail of this game.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Hawke were actually driving down Austria, Switzerland way, doing a trip to Italy a few days ago, and some of the countryside, like the country roads, were just amazing. Single lane roads like the one I'm driving on now, and just winding through the mountains and in and out of tunnels was just brilliant. Miles to go.
How can you drive on the wrong side of the road?
Do you remember that time we drove around in Europe for hours, came back to England and drove on the right side of the road? We're both from the UK, obviously, if you can't tell from our accents, and we drive on the left-hand side of the road. We drove in this game in Europe, which is on the right-hand side of the road, for a few hours, went back to England and continued driving on the right-hand side of the road. Until we both realised that we're in England.
Just feels natural.
It does now. But then I suppose the question is, if you're driving a lot in Europe, why don't you have a left-hand drive truck? I suppose the answer is because, well, I'm British and we'd have right-hand drive vehicles. And yep. To me, this just feels natural. Hours of the trip remaining. I unfortunately don't have the luxury of Oculus Rift, and I don't like moving my mouse around too much because it screws up my camera settings. So I just have to, when I come to T junctions, I just kind of go with it.
Fingers crossed.
99.9% of the time it's clear anyway, and you trucks will usually stop and let you come out.
Yeah, come to the T-junction, you don't want to move the camera. Press the tab button and it shows you the nearest players.
See, what would I do without you, Hawk? I'm doing that now, you see? And as you can see, the two trucks in front of me are listed on players near me. I hope these guys aren't going to where I'm going, because otherwise this is going to be a long trip. Not that I want to get there fast, obviously, because on this game, driving fast usually ends up with you having an accident somewhere along the line.
I'm bleeding.
That's not a feature of Euro Truck. How are you doing on your journey?
Hang on, let me open GPS. 600 miles to go, and there's been a smash ahead of me.
600 miles to go?
Yeah.
You're about halfway now.
Oh yeah, big smash. Yep. Good things are recording. I've got hiccups now. Oh, come on.
Drink, boy, drink. Another advantage of a 750 brake horsepower truck is it will go up hills. Quite fast.
Get out of the way.
It's the customary honk to oncoming drivers. I have two horns on this truck. I have this one, and then I have this one, which sounds much better.
Come on, get out of the way.
Oh, got some windy roads coming up here.
Move it.
Moo.
I'm going to have to undertake him now.
That's illegal. Do you know what
to do? He's just sticking on the left-hand side of the road.
You do get some horrible, nasty drivers on this game that just want to cause mayhem.
What an idiot.
Ooh, wobbling. I'm quite glad I picked the 6x4 configuration for this truck.
Yeah.
I think I would have struggled with the 4x2 because of the speed. I just would have been toppling all over the time.
Come
Well, it looks like we've got a little convoy going. I think these two trucks in front of me are part of the same group or a clan. They both have the same coloured trucks. Both carrying the same cargo, so I'm presuming they're part of the same.
Well, that's a weird thing that's happened to me then.
What's that?
Some guy just connected to the server, but was inside my trailer and just flipped. Well, I didn't flip, but the other guy flipped.
I'm just taking a slightly wide berth of these corners because I've had problems before where I've taken corners and still hit them, and the truck has literally flipped up and given me 100% damage and has ruined my trip. So I'm trying to be as careful as possible. I do have 3% damage on the truck anyway. That was done before this trip was taken. I had a slight bump on previous trip.
I've got 3% damage on my trailer within connected inside my trailer.
I've got 2% damage to the trailer. I don't know how that's happened. Shouldn't affect me too much. The company I deliver to will probably have a bit of a moan and go meh meh meh, but oh well. There's not much I can do about it. Again, customary honk to oncoming drivers. So, we are coming up to 8 hours of the driving left, 390 miles to go. Doesn't take very long in multiplayer, especially because you don't have AI traffic to worry about. So you're not constantly in the way of cars and vans and stuff. You do have other drivers to worry about, obviously other players, but most people usually move out the way. Just make sure there's no trucks coming up the motorway. Super fast speed. A lot of people you'll find are just parked on the side of the road, having a break.
Yeah.
Having a cup of tea and a Kit Kat. That's a chocolate biscuit for all you non-Kit Kat knowers. You know what I think we need to do, Hawk, for another video?
What?
A dubstep convoy. Do you remember when we did the last one?
I'll do it at night time, I'll turn my beacons on.
Me and Hawk, basically, we were trying out the radio stations that this game has, and if you press R when your truck's not moving, it comes up with a list of radio stations from all over Europe. And we found one, I think they were in Holland or Germany.
Yeah.
Dubstep ones. So for a giggle, we just decided to play them at full blast while sort of convoying down the road with beacons and headlights and everything on it. It's quite a mobile disco. Not that I generally listen to dubstep anyway. I think it's such awful, headachy music, but for trucking sim, it was alright.
My cabin partner's fell asleep.
Cabin partner.
Yeah.
Who's that then?
Chester.
Oh, the dog.
Yeah, the dog.
I was like,
just fell asleep.
We don't have cabin partners. To be honest, if I was in a cab with you, I'd be falling asleep. Your driving's woeful.
Hey, it's fun.
Mind you, my driving's not the best, I have to say. But, touch wood, we've not crashed yet on this game.
When you drive a keyboard,
I honestly haven't driven with a keyboard for such a long time. It'd be really alien for me to do it. It'd be quite primitive.
Yeah.
What are you listening to?
I don't know. It's an advert.
I think you're ahead of me on the stream.
I don't know.
Because you hear a song and then I hear it sort of about 2-3 minutes after.
Strange.
And this is the first of probably many tunnels here in northern Germany. Or southern Germany, wherever we are.
I don't know where I am.
I just follow the sat nav, I don't really bother.
I'm on the 45.
They're pulling over.
I don't know where about you are, because I'm on the 45.
I'm on the 6. Going through winding countryside and tunnel roads at the moment.
Strange. What the hell?
Sounds like it's from Lion King.
I think it is.
It's just come up on my radio.
You'll get the news in a minute. Listen to what Ralph Harris said. Apparently said in code that he's a touchy-feely person.
We don't comment on political.
At least I play as we do.
I should probably break now because this is quite a sharp end. Driving at 90 odd miles an hour with a 22 ton trailer isn't realistic, probably nor legal, but in trucking sim multiplayer you can do it if you have a powerful enough truck.
And if you don't.
And if you're feeling brave.
Oh, how fun.
Ralph Harris admits he's a touchy-feely person.
Sounds like you're in for some flooding tonight. No, for the next 48 hours.
Doesn't surprise me.
So the Met Office has been given a yellow warning for the east of England.
Did you see that lightning strike on the Shard in London?
I did. Looks amazing.
There was a video snippet on the BBC News website about it.
Yeah.
And as soon as the lightning strikes, you can hear like a load of women in the foreground going, "Ah!"
Women scream at anything.
I see the sign for Linz. We're 5 hours away, people.
I don't think I'm that far behind now. I think I'm about 300 miles, I think.
I'm 214 miles, so you're catching up with me.
I think you've checked my GPS. Oh no, 412.
Yeah. You gained 100 miles just by looking at your GPS.
Damn it!
I promise you people, I do use indicators and do follow the road law, but when I'm doing long distance hauls like this, I tend to sort of...
Racing lights.
Yeah, I tend to race. Safely, mind. I'm not a reckless driver by any means. I just like to sort of...
Get there quick.
Yeah. This is just a fun game to play. I don't take this that seriously, even though it's a simulator. If I wanted to take it seriously, I would just become a truck driver, for real. And do it for real, but that's not going to happen.
I thought you said drug driver then.
Drug driver?
I'd be a drug driver. Or a drunk driver.
I have driven this game while under the influence of several bottles of Stella Artois.
Who hasn't?
It's quite a fun experience. We tried to see how many accidents we avoid.
I got to add a pay to the charity then. Oh, no, I just didn't flip the truck. I'm good, in control.
It's sad I'm crazy for you. It's good to have a sing-along while you're trucking.
It is.
Rock out the tunes, get on Spotify, get on YouTube, listen to your favourite radio station, or just plug in your iPhone or whatever and just sing along.
I'm putting your favourite TV channel.
Yeah, if you've got your TV next to you, like I do, just put on Heart FM or Radio 1 or whatever. And just... Just saying. These roads are well quiet.
No, oh, I am. It's busy.
What am I doing for fuel? I'm alright for fuel. Oh, what about half a tank left?
I'm on five. I'm on five or six.
I'm on three.
I'm on five, it says.
We're going down in road numbers. I wonder if we'll end up on Mo again.
Mo.
There's a highway, motorway, freeway, whatever you want to call it, carriageway, on this game. I think it's in Poland, Austria.
Yeah,
it's called the M0, and on the sat nav, it just looks like you're riding at Mo.
Oh, get off the five. Coming to three, I think.
3 hours, 34 minutes remaining. We are now cruising down the highway at 92 miles an hour. No other trucks in sight.
Coming to three now.
This is the beauty of multiplayer. I'd never be able to do this in single player. There'd be cars, there'd be traffic, there'd be people changing lanes. It'd be bedlam. I think the most I'd be able to get out is about 60 miles an hour, if that. Over the little bridge. Go over those little bridges that make your stomach go into knots.
That pupil ticking in the place you don't want them to tickle.
I apologise for the wobble there. I am obviously driving at high speed, trying to activate the horn while trying to communicate with other drivers.
He's just drunk.
I'm not drunk. Not at 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
I would.
Oh, this is a big bridge. And you let it go.
Who go?
It's a song on the radio.
Hey, but who would you let go?
Anyone.
Here's a company called Shadow. I just found some called Shadow Killer. Because I found a Shadow Butler in Sheffield.
Yeah, it's not me.
I know, but then I saw Shadow Killer.
Might just be a clan.
Yeah.
If you are playing ETS multiplayer, and you want to come and truck and convoy me and Hawk, just give us a message on YouTube, or you can visit our website and say hello on the forum, or send us an email. We are also on Facebook and Twitter, and the moon. We're pretty much everywhere, really. We have a base on the moon. One hour, 42 minutes remaining.
7 hours, 6 minutes.
How long?
7 hours.
7 hours.
270 miles.
61 miles away.
I'm gashing you.
And you let it go.
For a while, but I feel like eating a burrito.
A burrito?
Yeah.
Taco meat.
A burrito.
Or a fajita.
an extra large burrito.
A fajita.
You've only just had
lunch, you fat sod.
Well, I'm hungry. Well, this is the prime example of someone who doesn't like you to overtake.
And speeding camera.
Give him to charity.
There you go. Which is, makes me laugh because we are on the autobahn, and I'm getting done for speeding. I think we are.
Aren't we in Poland?
No, we're in Austria, mate. If you're in Poland, you've gone way too far.
Oh yeah, going too far, Anna.
Going to Austria. Aye. I'm not sure if Austria still has the autobahn, or if they have speed rules on there.
Alright, is this guy going to let me pass, or is this going to be in? Is he going to be a little fool?
A little swine. Trailer's kicking out a bit, but we got round the bend. Last stretch now, guys. We're nearly home. There's the turn off for Linz. I think that's how you pronounce it anyway.
Yeah, I got a sign for Linz now.
Oh, what tune? When a man loves a woman.
When a man drives his Scania truck.
When a man smashes his Volvo,
he gets a fine.
He gets told off by the admins and then banned.
Can you let me through, Mr. BLL Global Andrea?
No.
Thank you. Let me through. What a boss.
We are 11 miles and 18 minutes away from destination.
5 hours.
I think this should be a mod where you get a talking sat nav. About the annoying woman voice you get on Tom Toms.
I love Billy Connolly.
Turn left now. I'd have like Katy Perry. If you're listening, Katy Perry, that's what you want to do. Get into sat navs. So many men would obey the road. Would obey the traffic laws and directions. It's not even funny. It'd probably upset their missus, but that's the risk you take when you have Katy Perry in the car.
Aye.
So, we've made it to Linz, and I'm pleased to say we did it without any crashes or bumps, scrapes, bruises, cuts.
Death.
Yeah. Any kind of mishap. I now have to find where I've got to deliver my trailer to.
Delivering to... I'm delivering to...
It's around the bend.
Sped. Or post-bed. I want to call it.
I'm delisting... delisting? Delivering.
Delisting.
Oh. To ITCC.
Uh-huh.
See, I used my indicators there. Proper correction. Now here comes the fun bit, ladies and gentlemen. Reversing the trailer. A skill I consider myself not too bad at, but mishaps do happen. Is there any way to turn around? What we'll do is we'll swing the trailer around, try not to jackknife.
Oh, servers went down again.
How is it?
Yeah, connection with the server's been broken.
Mine's still up at the moment.
Whoa!
Job has been done. Oh, good work.
Time has been reset.
For 2% damage, I'm still not sure where we got that from, but okay, we'll take it.
My game time has got reset again. I want to catch the server. Now 12:03.
I did notice the flash of sunlight as I was reversing my trailer. Yeah, 1204 I've got.
Yeah, same.
They must have reset the server. How far are you away, Hawk?
119.
Well, what we'll do, ladies and gentlemen, is we'll wait for Hawk, we'll say hello, and then we'll end the video. So I'm just going to drive around this little plant. Give me something to do. I could have come in that way. Oh, well. I followed the sat nav like a good driver.
Don't you.
So we'll have a quick look at my truck. There is my beast, my Volvo, with the rather unusual screwed up license plate names from the cab. That's not what I asked them to say. They should say PieFinder Butler, but there's a bug in multiplayer that just generates random names, and some of them are actually quite hilarious. At the moment, I'm called Einrad Alexei. This is the PieFinder paint job we're going for. It's called Duelist in the paint list. And the black and red, obviously, is the PieFinder colours. The beacons I've got up there for, obviously, transporting heavy loads. And just to warn other drivers that I'm coming. And the massive, rather long thunder horns there, which you can hear honking away.
You can't beat my 14 or 15 beacon lights.
14 or 15 beacons. We've got the high beam, front auxiliary, and the roof. There we go. That's it with all the lights on.
Sixty-seven miles.
Oh, you're getting close. Actually, should we come? Should we go and say hello to him? Should we meet him on the road?
Coming in from.
Let's see if we can find you.
I'm coming on the motorway. If you come to Linz, I'll be heading eastbound on my short motorway. That is.
Hang on, I'll have a look at the map.
There's a motorway south of Linz. I've been joining that off the A8. It's not speed map.
I know, you're coming up from the bottom.
Yeah.
You're on the A8 at the moment, are you?
Yeah, I'll literally just come around that, the left hand corner, coming south.
Yeah, okay, I'll meet you there. The beat's sitting around waiting in the factory for him to come. We can go say hello and escort him back to the factory. Now you'll see that the truck with 750 brake horsepower has super fast acceleration because I don't have a trailer on. My fuel's obviously gone up because I don't have a trailer on. These are the advantages of having a powerful truck.
Speed cameras. Cheese.
Try not to crash.
Okay, I'm coming on to the E60. Come to Linz.
You're on the E60, are you?
That's the main motorway that goes underneath Linz.
Yeah, I'm just leaving it now, coming on to you. So I'll probably pass you. The only thing is I've got to try and find a place to turn around the truck. Which I'll do here, actually.
And call it magic.
Don't worry, Hawk's not going to be applying for Britain's Got Talent anytime soon. It's like an episode of Traffic Cops now. Parking up, lying in wait for the suspect vehicle. Still got my beacons on like an idiot.
Okay, we're coming off now.
We're coming onto it.
No, coming off.
Coming off it?
Yeah.
Oh, off. I see you. Oh, you go up that way.
Yeah, I'm going the weird way.
bugger.
Reverse it back down. I'm clear down here.
People, if you're taking your driving test in real life, this is illegal. You're not allowed to do this. In tracking sim, it doesn't matter. Just to be safe, I'll put my hazards on.
Unless you're not OP, you got traffic coming down towards you.
Yeah, yeah, I can hear you. And this, what I'm about to do, is very illegal. But I'm gonna do it anyway. Because I'm gonna be a rebel. There we go. And there is John Hawke.
Hello.
Carrying his Digar. He is driving the Scania with the same paint colours, which I'll show you once he's got his trailer out. Why is your beacons not on?
Oh, no, one. There you go.
Breaking the law. There you go, there's his beacons on.
There's my 15 beacons.
Which, if you're looking from my camera, you'll notice that the beacon at the bottom middle half of the trailer is not actually flashing. It's flashing further up. So that's a little bug. Apparently he's limited to 70 kilometres an hour. I think that's kilometres anyway.
I think so too.
But we don't abide by those rules. I'm just going to keep my distance from Hawk because obviously playing multiplayer and lagging, rubber banding and stuff, I don't want to have the rear end of his trailer in my face.
Prospect.
Come on. Break.
Beep beep. Grab this ball, please.
I'm just going to park over here and watch Hawk reverse his trailer like a pro.
Oh, now he moves. Thank you. And head out the window.
Left a bit, right a bit.
I know how to do it.
Left hand down.
Pro.
Did you pro it?
Proper pro. Turn beings off.
So we'll just drive out here and let these guys collect their trailers.
Ooh, traffic.
The Tominator. Driving a man truck. Whee,
find me. Oh, I think I know this place, anyway. This is a... like a terminal or somewhere. That's what I think. Maybe not.
We'll just park up here. And we'll say goodbye to these lovely people. Just show them our awesome trucks. We'll just park here. So, as you can see, these are our trucks. There you go, he's driving his Scania. You can't actually see the players driving the truck. Yeah. And he does have 500 million beacons on his truck. So he is a mobile disco. Well, that's been Butler and Hawke from PieFinders. We hope you've enjoyed this video. We will see you again shortly with another road trip, I imagine.
Aye.
And from us, it's bye-bye.
Aye.
Oh, it's raining.